This is Direct News. I'm Scott Muni. Rachel Sweet is what you might call a child star. She's just turned 17, and she's already had two popular singles and an album that's established her as a tough new voice in rock. Rachel comes from Akron, Ohio, and spent years in summer stock groups and making TV and radio commercials before getting into music. Stiff Records signed her, and her debut album, Fool Around, was released first in England, resulting in an American contract. Rachel Sweet talks to Direct News reporter Patrick Carr about trying to stay normal in the hubbub of success.
I wonder maybe if you're afraid of getting like exposed too much and being put through the star machinery and having all the hassles that go along with kind of a rock and roll career, or whether maybe you've had so many careers before that you just you feel pretty tough about it.
Yeah, I don't feel like anything is going to make me commit suicide. It all depends, I think, on your home life. It all goes back to that. So if you have a stable home life, if you enjoy what you're doing, you aren't so overly concerned with your own self-importance, and you don't think that what you're giving to the world is something nobody else can give, then you're all right. If you consider yourself a human being and you go home at night and your sister still hits you, you know that you're still down on earth. And I think what happens to a lot of these rock and roll stars, which is so cliche of the rock and roll field, is that they're out in front of audiences every night and they scream and they shout and they say you're great and you're wonderful. And I think something may happen to their mind, and they can't handle the fact they've also got to live everyday lives. They've also got to sleep in a different hotel room every night. Mm-hmm. They've also got to eat at the right times of the day, you know. And that's, I think that's what happens to a lot of rock and roll stars. And that's why it happens most in rock and roll, because they're traveling around so much, being appreciated live by so many people. Well, everything is going in the wrong direction.
You reached a point where you were very savvy in show business terms, you know, and you really knew what you were doing and so on and so forth. And all the people outside of you would be kind of considering you as a kid, you know.
Yeah.
Did that ever grate on you?
I was in the know, and yet they, well, you still get record company people who want to say, okay, Rachel, turn here, turn there, and sing this and sing that. And it's not that I feel that I am that adult about anything, but I just think I should be able to decide where I should go and what I should sing. I'm an artist, I'm not just a singer. You know, I like to decide a lot of the things about my own career. And see, it's hard getting people to take you seriously. But you know, a few years from now I'll be 20, so people can't say you're still a kid then.
17-year-old rock singer, Rachel Sweet. This is Direct News.
Mostly a few quite together, my feet on solid ground. When things start taking me, I can always bring myself back down. But baby, when I shoot me straight, I'm speaking in a foreign tongue. I'm crazy in the night time, there's something going on.
Thank you. We're back. And my next guest to join us here is the youngest guest we've had so far on the Robert Klein Hour, except for Jane Fonda. She's a fine singer, and she's just starting out. This kid is sensational. Will you welcome Rachel Sweet? Rachel, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Which speaker are you on? Remember those ping pong demonstrations, the old choo-choo train stereo demonstrations?
No.
You don't. Weisenheimer, right? Well, here I just was tormenting Robert Gordon for 10 minutes about, gee, it sounds like a 60s rockabilly sound, you know. Everyone's saying that it's sort of what you sound like, it's sort of Brenda Lee-ish. How do you feel about that?
I don't know. I never heard her, really. No, I'm really. I mean, I heard, I'm sorry, but that's about it.
I'm sorry. So sorry. Yeah. People always sang with a lisp in the 50s and 60s. I'm sorry. So sorry. Good laugh for Rachel. Listen, I listened to your album, and it's terrific. And first of all, I said to a friend of mine, I said, Andy? I said, I'm having a... And Rachel's... I just saw the other night. You played with Southside Johnny?
Yeah, in the park.
Well, isn't that something? That's.
It was, yeah.
Yeah. And you're hardly even a grown-up. I'm not either,
okay.
Actually.
Okay.
You've really been in show business for a little while, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tell us about that. And from Akron, Ohio, no less.
So?
Well, I mean... exactly the show business capital of the world, Akron. There is a bowling alley, but... and believe me, I like bowling, except I was tired of renting shoes, though. It's a repulsive thing. It's like renting a Kleenex or something. But tell me how you had a show business career in from Akron.
I used to run around the house and do TV commercials, for my parents. And they just thought I did as well as the kids on TV. Mm-hmm. So I used to come in twice a month to New York and audition for commercials.
Gee.
Yeah.
And you got a few?
Couple.
What kind of things did you do?
The kids' products.
Kids' stuff?
Yeah, Caramel candy bars, But I never got any of it, though.
Yeah. No. They never gave you samples?
That's right,
or something?
No. No, they did. I mean, you used to have to take bites at the end of the commercial.
Let me ask you an honest question. Are you excited? Things are going... This is not children's commercials anymore.
No.
This is a... You're sizzling and you're going up there and there's a lot of promise. This new album called Fool Around.
Yeah.
Rachel Sweet, and it's got a cute picture of you.
They didn't want to use a shot because there's some girl in it.
Yeah.
That wasn't me. And so, but then I said use it, and so they said
you have to see it and interpret it for yourself. It comes out interesting.
Yeah, because I look sort of tough, And, then
and she looks kind of like she's Mary Little Lamb.
Yeah,
right,
the Bobby Sox.
Well, what is that supposed to mean? Are you tough? Want to duke it out right here in front of all these people? And see,
after the show.
I read a quote where you said, everybody over 25 is forbidden. What does that mean? I happen to be 37. What am I supposed to make out of that?
I didn't say that.
I swear, that's what it said in Rolling Stone. You'll have to sue them. Unless it was a press release. What about it? You had to travel with an all-boys band.
Oh, yeah, I did that.
And, you're a young girl, a young woman, shall we say, traveling with an all-boys band. You said, oh, don't worry about that.
Don't worry about that, no.
You can't smoke because of your voice. You can't drink because...
Because I go crazy.
Go crazy? That was the explanation for that. So... And you said everybody over 25 is forbidden here. We got to mark this. Give her a lie detector test.
I didn't say that.
Yeah. Did your family, somebody in your family want you to be a lawyer?
Yeah, me.
Really?
Yeah, because, I was singing country music for about 4 years, and that was not cool with the kids at school.
Why?
Who listens
because?
To...
Because?
Because you're going to Firestone High, right?
Yeah.
And you're... This is not funny.
This is boom-ba, rah-rah-rah, alabam, ta-ta-ta.
You go to Firestone High, and they listen to Styx and Boston and ELO. Mm-hmm. Not that there's anything.
Mm-hmm. And, sorry, Robert.
But they don't listen.
Right,
they
Robert
don't.
They, in fact, there's a movement now, Robert. I'm serious.
Who does we
No, but it was always the big groups that they listened to. Yeah. And so, you know, they didn't listen to Loretta Lynn, and it wasn't just, it just wasn't cool.
It was not a country school, and here you are singing country.
And yeah, and I was singing country. Mm-hmm.
So whatever, they throw stones at you? I mean, what's the big
crowd? No, they just never came to the fairs. They just sang. It was just like...
Well, how did you feel about that music?
Well, it was okay. I mean, it was... I sang it because there was really no market for a 12-year-old girl in rock and roll.
Listen to this. No market for a 12-year-old girl. What are you, an accountant?
No, there wasn't. I
Move over,
no,
president
look,
of the record
But you don't see anybody really that's 12 years old, right, that has a lot of big rock and roll. You see the teeny bop kind of
stuff, right?
But you don't see it. And so country music can be very respectable, you know? So I went into country music.
You kidding? We had Roy Orbison here. He gave me glasses. Sorry. He gave me dark Roy Orbison glasses. Go ahead, I'm listening. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have interrupted you there. So we all make mistakes.
Okay.
You're gonna look at me with make me guilty for the next 15 minutes? Go ahead. Country music can be respected.
Yeah, so country music. So I started singing country music because I was thinking of people like Tawny Tucker, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Who was making it at that age.
Right.
So that's what I did. And then when I turned legally old enough for rock and roll.
Right. To be legally old enough for rock and roll, you have to be 8. What's legally old?
I still can't get into the clubs I play in.
You're 17, yeah.
Yeah.
So believe me, it'll come fast enough. Don't rush it.
Okay,
I'm not. Don't take any hormones or anything. Is that really your voice?
What?
You got to protect that voice. That's your treasure.
Am I talking voice?
No, I'm just kidding. You got to protect that voice. I asked you if you... Because you can really belt it out. You know,
yeah.
I asked you. You do a lot of performances. You could hurt your voice.
Yeah. Oh, I have before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Is that kind of wear and tear?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is your treasure. What would you like to do? I mean, what kind of things would you like to happen? What kind of things would you like to do? Would you like to do some acting?
Oh, how far are we projecting here?
Far.
Okay,
let's
so
say
far,
things
so
fall
far,
into place.
20 years?
No.
Not that far.
20 years, way too far.
Okay.
I'm talking about the next several years.
You know, I'd like to have
Let's say audiences everywhere going,
Rachel.
Let's say the President of the United States calls a press conference. My fellow Rachel. They won't let him talk. They won't let anything. They won't.
I want some hit records. It's okay.
Yeah. Right now, recording is...
I like to do live stuff. I'd like to go into everything.
Yeah.
You know, everything has its time.
Yeah. So, you like performing live in front of people, getting the feedback?
Oh, yeah. I don't think I'll quit doing that. It's not for a long time. I mean, that's sort of like...
Your new album, Fool Around.
Fool Around.
Who is that fellow that wrote so much of the material?
Oh, Liam Sternberg. He's my father's best friend's son.
Can you repeat that, please? What's the connection?
He's my father's best friend's son, and his father is my lawyer.
He's a lawyer, this guy?
No, his father's my lawyer.
Well, you know, lawyers can be good songwriters. Francis Scott Key wrote The Star-Spangled Banner. He was a lawyer.
That was before my time.
Timing is excellent. We may have could be the bionic performer. Maybe she has everything, the perfect timing and the rhythm and all.
No
well, let me tell you something. I've had a wonderful time having you cut me down to normal size.
Anytime.
And you know, I'll have to sharpen up the next time we meet. Be destroyed by a teenager. Anyway, we'll be right back with the end of this abuse right after this word from Anheuser-Busch.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis.
I want to thank you, all of you, including you, even though you abused a grown-up. Me, Rachel Sweet, and Robert Gordon, and Bev Bevan of ELO. Wish you all success. It was a delight having you. And thank you, Dennis, for the Top 20 review and your help on just your presence. You're a class guy. The audience here, wonderful as usual, making it all lots of fun and witnessing this. And you folks out there, especially on the pike, get home safely. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.